In this webcast, we want to continue our discussion of the acid-base properties of different heterocyclic systems. In this first example, we want to compare the acid-base properties of the imidazole structure versus pyridine and pyrrole. So if we key in on the neutral species imidazole here in the middle, and we follow the reaction to the left, as imidazole is a base, it picks up a proton, but it picks up that proton on the nitrogen on the left and not on the nitrogen on the right. Now we can easily explain this if we go back and look at the neutral species and look and see that the nitrogen on the left in imidazole is an N2 nitrogen and the nitrogen on the right is an N3 nitrogen. Now we know from the previous webcasts that the differences between N2 and N3 and the lone pair in the N2 is not tied up in the aromatic system, while the lone pair in the N3 nitrogen is tied up in the aromatic system. Therefore, the lone pair on the left is free to be a base or nucleophile. So we want to answer this question also. We want to key in on this pKa here of 6.99 for the conjugate acid of imidazole. And we don't want to compare that to the pKa of 5.2 for the conjugate acid of pyridine. Now this shows that the imidazole conjugate acid is a weaker acid, a more stable structure than the pyridine conjugate acid. How can we rationalize that this structure is more stable and is a weaker acid? If we look here at the bottom of the slide and we see the different resonance contributors to the conjugate acid of the imidazole structure, we can see that the lone pair is delocalized over both nitrogens. And we know that if we spread out a charge over different atoms, that it's more stable and less reactive. So again, the conjugate acid of imidazole is more stable because the resonance contributors delocalize that positive charge over more atoms versus the pyridine conjugate acid, where it's not delocalized. Now in this example, we want to compare pyrimidine versus pyridine. So the neutral species pyrimidine here, we want to follow this reaction from left to right. So the conjugate acid of pyrimidine, shown here on the left, as it is an acid and gives up a proton, the pKa is shown over here with a 1. So we want to compare that pKa to the pKa of 5.2 in pyridine. So we note that the lower the pKa, the stronger the acid. So this conjugate acid is a much stronger acid than the pyridine conjugate acid. So how can we rationalize this? Well, first we see this large dipole shown by this red arrow here shows that this ring is electron deficient. So an electron deficient ring should have a hard time stabilizing a positive charge shown in the conjugate acid, and in fact that is the case. And again, in the conjugate acid of this pyrimidine system, there is no delocalization of the charge with the lone pairs, as we saw in the case of the imidazole on the last slide. So combining those two factors, we can understand why the conjugate acid of pyrimidine is a stronger acid, a more reactive species, than the conjugate acid of pyridine. And one last example, we want to consider pyridine versus purine. So if we follow this reaction from left to right, we see that the pKa of the conjugate acid of pyrine is 2.5, and that shows us that it's a stronger acid than the conjugate acid of pyridine with the 5.2 that we've been comparing to. And again, it's worth noting that the ring system on the left is electron deficient, and the ring system on the right is electron rich.